Hello, good morning. This is Yatish Kumar. Welcome to Zoology Online Guru. Today's topic is exchange of gases. What is meaning of respiration? The exact meaning of the respiration is intaking of the oxygen, removing of the carbon dioxide, along with the transport of the gases, and then exchange of the gases from the tissues to the blood, and within the tissues the oxygen enters into the mitochondria and produces energy currency ATP. So all these events collectively known as respiration. Today's topic is exchange of gases, how the oxygen and CO2 exchange from the lungs to the blood and from the blood to the tissues and tissues to the blood. How these gases are exchanged, that is our topic. Before entering into our topic, please subscribe my channel Zoology Online Guru. Okay, now exchange of gases. And if you want to know the exchange of gases very well, for the better understanding, you have to know two concepts. One is simple diffusion. Second concept, partial pressure. What is meaning of simple diffusion? Simple diffusion is the process of movement of gases from high pressure or high partial pressure to the low partial pressure. That is called diffusion. Partial pressure is the pressure contributed by a single gas in a mixture of gases. That is called partial pressure. Now, exchange of gases is completely depend on the simple diffusion, a physical phenomena, and partial pressure. This table indicates the partial pressure of oxygen and carbon dioxide. Look here, respiratory gases, oxygen and carbon dioxide, and in the atmosphere 159 units, and CO2 is 0.3 units. Like that, in the alveoli, lungs, oxygen is 104, the partial pressure is 104, and CO2 is 40. Like impure blood, oxygen partial pressure is 40, and whereas carbon dioxide partial pressure is 45, and in the pure blood, oxygen partial pressure is 95 units, and whereas the carbon dioxide partial pressure is 40, and in the tissues, lastly in the tissues, impure blood and tissues both are have the same partial pressure. That means oxygen is 40 units and carbon dioxide 45 units. So this table is most important to know about the exchange of gases. The solubility of the CO2 is 20 to 25 times greater than the oxygen. That is why the diffusion of the CO2 is much higher than the oxygen when it is diffusing through a diffusing membrane. The diffusion membrane is made up of three layers. One, a thin squamous epithelial layer of alveolus, a basement membrane, and the endothelium of the alveolar capillary. So it is one of the thinnest layer. This membrane used for the simple diffusion of the gases. Now our topic is exchange of gases from alveoli to the blood capillary. Diffusion membrane is made up of three layers. First layer, alveoli squamous epithelial membrane, middle basement membrane, third layer alveolar capillaries, endothelium membrane. So these three layers behaves as a diffusion membrane. First, how the gaseous exchange takes place through alveoli into the blood capillary. So this is the atmospheric air. As per table, oxygen is 159 units in the atmosphere. So 159 units partial pressure oxygen enters into the alveoli and then converted into 104 partial pressure PO2. Partial pressure of the oxygen is 104 alveoli and PCO2 is 40. PCO2 is 40 in the alveoli. And the blood coming near to the alveoli means the impure blood reaches the lungs for purification. You know very well that blood is purified in the lungs. For that purpose, the impure blood reaches the alveolus. So the alveolar capillaries contain the impure blood. Impure blood, the PO2 is 40 and PCO2 alveolar blood capillary is 45. This is the partial pressure at the level of alveolus. So partial pressure of oxygen is 104 and in the blood capillaries, that is PO2 is 40. So simple diffusion, transfer of movement of gases from high partial pressure to the low pressure, then the oxygen enters into the blood capillaries. Same time, the partial pressure of CO2 is 45 in the alveolar capillaries, and in the alveolus, the partial pressure of CO2 is 40. So, high concentration to the low concentration, CO2 enters into the alveolus. So, this is the gaseous exchange at a lungs level. So, first exchange of gases based on the partial pressure. The impure blood is now purified. This purified blood enters into the left atrium and then to the left ventricle in the heart, and through the left ventricle, through systemic aorta, it enters into the all the parts of the body. Alveolus, right atrium, left atrium, ventricles, body, tissues. In the alveolus, partial pressure of oxygen is 104, partial pressure of CO2 is 40. Okay, and here the purified blood enters into the left atrium. So this is the pure blood. This vessel is called pulmonary vein. Pulmonary vein carries pure blood from the lungs towards the left atrium, then enters into the left ventricle, and from the left ventricle the
pure blood enters into the
every part of the body. So here the target organ is the tissues. In the tissues, the partial pressure is PO2 is 40, PCO2 is 45.
So in the tissues, PO2 is 40 and PCO2 is 45 in the tissue level. The pure blood, this pure blood contains, pure blood contains PO2. Here PO2 is 95 and PCO2 is 40. So high concentration to the low concentration, oxygen diffused into the tissues, whereas the partial pressure of CO2 in the tissues is 45, whereas in the pure blood it is only 40. So high concentration is the 45 in the tissues, that is why CO2 enters into the blood capillaries through simple diffusion. Means the pure blood, this is the pure blood, then convert into the impure blood once again. Oxygenated blood at a tissue level through systemic aorta or systemic arteries, the oxygenated blood reaches the tissues, where tissues already exhausted with oxygen and the CO2 is abundantly present in the tissues. That is why the PCO2 in the tissues is much more when comparing to the oxygenated blood. That is why CO2 is diffused into the blood capillaries and oxygen diffused into the tissues because of the difference in the partial pressure. Then the deoxygenated blood from tissues reaches the right atrium and then to tricuspid wall, enters into the right ventricle, and this deoxygenated blood once again reaches the lungs for purification. Means the impure blood, the P-oxygen is 40 and PCO2 is 45. So in this range, it reaches the alveoles, the lungs. In the lungs, oxygen partial pressure is much more higher. It is 104 and here only 40. That is why the oxygen diffused into the pulmonary vein. Like that, the CO2 enters into the alveoles. So ultimately, the impurity, carbon dioxide, reaches the alveoles. Through the alveoles, the CO2 expired outside through nose. So from the alveoles to the blood capillary or pulmonary vein, this is the first exchange of gas. Whereas second exchange of gas also takes place in our body at a tissue level, from the systemic aorta or systemic artery to the tissues. Here second gaseous exchange takes place like this. In our body, two types of gaseous exchange takes place based on the simple diffusion and the phenomena of partial pressure. Thank you. Thanks for watching my video. Like the video, share the video and subscribe my channel, Zoology Online Group. Thank you.